Yeah, it was a tough series. Like you said, the pitches were very flat and placid. Good for batting on. To be honest, though, most test pitches around the world are like that, and we as bowlers have to figure out ways of getting 20 wickets on those pitches. And if we're honest, we didn't bowl as well as we could do. So, we're gonna have to try and learn or take what we can from that series and try and improve going into the summer.
From your point of view, I bet you can't wait now just to get rid of that Kookaburra ball and get the Duke back in your hand.
Yeah, it's well. To be honest, just playing in England is nice. Being at home, you've got home comforts here, and we're sort of more familiar conditions. So yeah, it's nice to be here and know that we've got a Duke's ball to bowl with.
Coming up against some batsmen who did okay against you in the series that's about to start. You've been working now with the analyst on looking at how to get those guys out?
Yeah, we're constantly, is that a word? Yeah, we're always looking to figure out how to win games of cricket and how to get batsmen out from a bowler's point of view. So we've learnt a lot about their batsmen from the series we've just played against them. Hopefully the English conditions will help us a little bit more, and hopefully we can put some good plans into place to get them out.
They show that they're a fighting side, certainly. You expect them to come out fighting in the first test next week.
Yeah, whenever I've played against New Zealand, they've always been a really strong side and a team that always puts up a good fight. So I don't expect anything different here. We know it's going to be difficult. We've got a huge summer ahead, so we really want to kickstart the summer with a good series win.
And the fact that lots of people are talking about this being the summer of the back-to-back, well, the year of the back-to-back Ashes, the way New Zealand played has almost played into your hands that now you've got to go out and be really competitive against those guys and can really push Australia to the back of your mind for now. That might have been less difficult, I guess, if you'd been over to New Zealand and won 3-0.
Yeah, possibly. We know we've got to start well. They're going to come over here and think they can beat us, so we're going to have to start strongly. And I think when we play at our best, we do think about the present rather than looking too far ahead into the future. I think if we start looking towards the Ashes and things like that, then we can take our eye off the ball. And what's happening now, so we've really got to concentrate hard on that.
You must look a little forward though, because you've got 298 test wickets now, overtaking Derek Underwood in New Zealand, fifth on the list. You just want those two wickets as quick as you can get them. Where would you like to get those? At Lord's?
I don't mind anywhere, as long as I get them. To be honest, milestones and things like that aren't something I focus on or use to spur me on. My job is to take wickets for the team and help us to win games of cricket. So, I'll just concentrate on doing that, and hopefully the wickets will take care of themselves.
So this will be something that when you retire and hang up your boots, you'll be looking back on the amount of wickets you took.
Yeah, exactly. I can sit my grandkids down and talk them through all of them, which they'll love. But yeah, it is something that you. I think milestones and stats are something that you can sort of look back on with fond memories once you finish your career. But whilst I'm playing, I certainly try and concentrate on helping the team to win.